You better watch it. You're gonna smack somebody with that.
It came backwards.
Are you gonna fly sideways now? Come here. Dance. He almost hit the straddles. Hi-ya!
This is my apartment complex, and it is so fucking smoky right now. I'm trying to get my sister over. She lives around the corner from me in another building. I don't know where she's at. I told her to come over. It's already 10 o'clock at night, but I ain't complaining. I love fireworks. Look at the bright spotlights. Trying to catch the other fireworks that's back here by that light behind that building there. But that spotlight is so bright, you can barely see them. You can barely move my finger right there. Right in this area, you can really see him. And Bubby, I call him Bubby, is James, Kathleen's fiance. He's messaging me, so I'm gonna check that real quick. Okay, so he was just making sure my son was okay, because when we saw fireworks Saturday night, he was freaking out. So, today is Monday, July 4th. So, Saturday was the 2nd, and that's when we watched the fireworks at Thomas Cloud Park in Huber Heights, Ohio. Oh! Oh my god! No, it was by the guy's van. Everybody. So I got a hold of my sister and her fiance. I'm headed over there now. I got my phone recording and it's on a selfie stick. So I'm walking to their apartment. I'm not even kidding right now. When I say they live around the corner, I mean they live around the corner. Like, I'm still on my street. Like, I live way back here. Hi, sis! Hi, Sadies!
Smell my hair.
Oh my gosh, your hair smells good!
What are you doing?
Now I know you. What the?
You coming in?
Yeah.
Me too.
So, Dominic fell asleep, so Nate's staying behind.
Look right there.
If.
Huh? Right there.
Who?
Fireworks.
Oh. And I told Nate if Dominic wakes up, just to bring him down here. Okay. So.
Did you walk here?
Yes, I did.
You better go up back, right?
Man, they are letting off boomers, smoke bombs, and everything.
I can't find my selfie stick.
Yeah.
Oh. Hi, honey.
How are you?
Oh,
my phone number scared?
Now. Yeah.
Oh, is Dominic's freaking out?
No, he's asleep.
He like it?
Yeah. He fell asleep.
Told him he like it.
Are you recording?
Yes, I am.
For?
My video, my channel.
I knew it. Look, she put streamers in my hair from the one of the things we pop.
That's cute.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. Alright, everybody.
So you know the flash on.
There's Kathleen and James for getting ready to do a ceremony for her miscarriage. She's got auction out pictures in her hands that everybody wrote a little message on.
Yeah. Okay. I pray that my little brother or sister will have an awesome time wherever they're at. And I hope that Kathleen will move on a little bit. And we can all, I don't know.
Say whatever you feel.
Say whatever comes to mind.
We all love you.
Yeah.
No, you're not.
We all love you. Anybody else want to say anything?
No.
Which is you?
Why not?
Nobody else
want to say Victor? I just want to say that, if I can not cry. I really hope that you guys get what you want. And I'm sorry for your loss.
That this is bullshit. Why the fuck it had to happen?
I mean, we may not know why it happened. It just happened.
It's bullshit.
But, you know, we'll always remember everything. And we'll keep her or him in our thoughts and prayers and remember her or him. And that we just want what's best for you guys. And we hope you guys get what you want.
You
want to
say anything, Tree?
Zach? Victor? Never?
You say something.
No, you.
It's that. Your baby.
I'm just going to say I'm getting it back.
Stay positive.
Yep, think positive.
I'm going to say, like Daddy said, we're going to get you back. And if it's a girl this time, I want to change her name. If it's a girl and if it's a full time, I want to change her name to a miracle.
You right, Crystal?
I don't know. I'm thinking.
Brian?
Brian?
I said it's not nice, and I know. I think it's
bullshit.
But I think this is bullshit. This should never happen. Because why is it that when good people do things that they get punished, but the ones that don't, they get away?
Exactly.
And it's bullshit that the people that do want kids can't have them or want them, but the ones that don't, they don't want them. They want to drown them, drug them, fry them, bake
kill
them.
Something.
And I think this is wrong.
It is. It's not fair because there's so many parents out there who's trying so hard, you know, to have a family, and they can't have that. And all the bad people who are, like you said, wanting to drug them, cook them, you know, just want to hurt these innocent, poor, beautiful kids. They get that gift. They get that chance, the miracle, to become a parent. And they don't want to accept the responsibilities that come with it. So they do horrible things to these innocent children. And it's not fair. And I pray that one day things will come and turn around. And that God will grant everybody who deserves these children and the family, you know, and the ones who don't deserve it don't get that chance.
Okay, what I was gonna say was, I even told Amy this one. I said that you are meant to have what you're given. In my opinion, God's there to watch over you and to make sure that you have what you need when you need it and when it's your turn to have it. And obviously, for some reason, God felt the need that it wasn't meant to be for her to have this specific baby. Maybe later on down the road, there'll be another one. and God will think that's the one for her. Because maybe she wasn't ready. Maybe God felt that there was something about her that wasn't ready to have another child yet. And that's the reason why she didn't get this one. That's what I told Amy when her twins died. Maybe it wasn't the time for her to have kids, and then when she has one, it'll be the time. And then God's watching over the one that she was meant to have.
Right. I'm a firm believer that if God brings you to it, he will see you through it. He's there with you.
I believe that God will never give you more than what you can handle.
Exactly.
And if you can, and if he obviously thought you could handle the death of a child, then he obviously thought you were a strong person and you deserve to get better.
Exactly.
Better.
And like I told you guys in the car on the way home from that appointment, I really hope that you guys will stay strong and work together to get through this and cope with this and not go against each other. You know, I feel this is a test on you guys individually to see what happens with you guys.
I'm going to cope with things. Do it.
Well, shit. And then if that's the case, I cope with things. I just want to break something or shoot somebody.
Spend all your time waiting. For a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough. And it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction.
Too far from their apartment in Mountain View. So for those who are new to my channel and still watching the video, my best friend Kathleen, she has a YouTube channel. The link is in the description box below. She recently had a miscarriage. So she was 6 weeks, 9 weeks. Something like that. I can't remember. And then she had to have a DNC done. So, I mean, that's my best friend. I've never seen her since third grade. So, she's practically my sister. So, I've been there for her, with her going through everything. Her fiancé, James, from Insane Bros. That link is also down there in the description box. He's been going with her to appointments and stuff. So, I've been there for both of them. And it's foggy out. So yeah, seems like everything started to die down a little bit. People are starting off little bitty things here and there. And it's getting foggy out, so I told them I would hang out for a couple minutes and then I get to head home. It's almost midnight. So.